Oh, I'm a terrible swimmer. I'm really, really bad.
There are so many captivating scenes in the Harry Potter series, you'd be surprised at which ones the cast struggled with. We're talking awkward kissing scenes, freezing cold water, and horrific, painful onset injuries.
That looks really painful.
So painful.
Number 1. There's always a dreaded kissing scene. Towards the end of the trio's journey, they defeat a Horcrux in the Chamber of Secrets. Emotionally overwhelmed, Ron and Hermione embrace and kiss for the first time.
It was the most horrible thing I've had to do.
Though there are tons of fans who ship the iconic duo, Emma Watson and Rupert Grint definitely weren't as into it. Not that they don't think highly of each other, it's just that their relationship is more like brother and sister in real life.
It just felt like incest. That's the only way I can describe it.
Number 2, when Grand Theft Dragging goes wrong. When we first get into Deathly Hallows Part 2, Harry, Ron, and Hermione break into Gringotts, grab a Horcrux, and escape on the back of a dragon. Obviously, things can never pan out that smoothly, and they soon have to jump off and dive into a lake. Not only was the lake freezing cold, but the actors had to swim back to shore and do it over and over again. In an interview with Coming Soon, Emma Watson shares a lot about the dreaded day. Because we had to get changed as part of the next scene, we couldn't wear anything underneath. I was lucky. I had my bottom half with some thermals on, but I was like, this must be a joke. It was so cold. I think Rupert thought at one point that his heart had stopped beating.
He feels more dangerous.
Number 3. It seems like anything with water proves a major challenge. In Goblet of Fire, there's a moment where the participants have to dive into the water and retrieve something of importance to them. The actors perform their own stunts at a specifically built state-of-the-art production tank at Leavesden Studios. One thing you might not know about Daniel Radcliffe is that he's actually a really terrible swimmer. But for most of these swim sequences, he's underwater for up to 2 hours at a time.
Sort of have a mode of just being like, I'll just keep smiling and laughing.
Yes.
And hopefully this will end soon.
Number 4, just burn the whole place down. The most significant similarity between Rupert Grint and his character Ron is that they both have a crippling fear of spiders.
I hate spiders, I'm an arachnophobe.
That's why in the Chamber of Secrets, Rupert was significantly underwhelmed to face off against a giant horde of spiders. Rupert shared with BBC that, I don't like spiders in real life. Even rubber ones, I get really scared of. Though most of them were brought to life with CGI, there was a huge animatronic model used for Aragog, the biggest spider of the group. Like we said, just burn it all down.
Wait, spiders? Why couldn't it be follow the butterflies?
Number 5. One of the most glamorous yet difficult scenes for Emma Watson. This moment was huge for Hermione, as neither Ron nor Harry thought to ask her to the ball because they only see her as their friend, their sidekick. But when she walks down those stairs, that's when things change. Emma talks about the immense pressure she was faced with during the Harry Potter 20th anniversary return to Hogwarts. Mike Newell coached me to walk down the stairs in the dress.
Don't swing your arms. Okay.
He gives me a million different directions about how to walk down the stairs.
And of course, I fell down the stairs.
Number 6. Speaking of falling, the Goblet of Fire was full of intense challenges and stunts. But this one in particular, when Harry was faced with a Hungarian horntail, had Daniel Radcliffe hanging from a wire 40 feet up in the air.
Fell, I think, 40 feet. And quite very, very fast, actually. That was really, really terrifying. And I'm not afraid to admit that.
Number 7. We're talking feasts of rotting food. Yeah, not gonna lie, this one is kind of a bummer, as the Great Hall always looked like the most fun place to have a meal. But actually, not so much. The first day was the best, because they would serve fresh food. But then on day 2, 3, 4, it was still the same food. Warwick Davis, who plays Professor Flitwick, talks about it in an interview with Mirror. The fourth day, you could smell the Great Hall before you got in it. The food was the same food, and it had quite an amazing smell.
Do you ever stop eating?
Oh, I'm hungry.
Number 8. Not a very fun Breakfast Club experience. When Harry returns to Hogwarts for his 5th year, nobody believes him about Voldemort's return. He even gets made fun of by Professor Umbridge, which, naturally, results in Harry getting detention. Off-screen though, Imelda Staunton, who plays Umbridge, had a lot more empathy than her character. She talks with Entertainment Weekly about how guilty she felt after shooting that scene. Gosh, we're all capable of great cruelty. It was a horrible, horrible feeling. Number 9. Another one that's cool to look at, but not so cool to be in. In the Order of the Phoenix, Harry and a bunch of other Hogwarts students decide to blow off their usual studies and practice spells in the Room of Requirement. Apparently, due to the number of fires going on and how many people were in the room, it was pretty unbearable to be in.
I got really claustrophobic in it.
Yeah, and hot.
Because it's just like really hot.
Number 10. Still reeling from this one. So we all know Cedric gets hit by the Killing Curse, but what you may not know is to simulate the power of the hit, Robert Pattinson had to go through quite a bit of pain throughout each take. He opens up about it during an interview with Lifestyle. If you're just being pulled back the conventional way, it doesn't hurt too much because you're just landing on your back.
But that one, they had to be like a coil. I had to get hit in my groin.
Number 11. Fun to watch, but not so fun to shoot. Although we love seeing Quidditch matches on screen, apparently all that came with it was a sore butt and getting hit in the face with quaffles. In an interview with Belfast Telegraph, Daniel Radcliffe says, "Quidditch is right up there with the least fun things I've done in Harry Potter. It does hurt quite a lot and it's not something I would rush back to." Number 12. This one is actually pretty wild. While portraying her character, Bellatrix Lestrange, Bonham Carter got a little too method as she was torturing her co-star Matthew Lewis, who plays Neville. When using her wand to poke and prod at his ear, Matthew moved a little too close to it, and it ended up perforating his eardrum. It did cause internal bleeding, but he couldn't bear to admit it to her at the time.
That was terrible. I felt really mortified.
Number 13. We all go through it. Being a teenage boy, it's pretty natural to want to impress girls. But for Matthew Lewis, he found it to be near impossible on set. He talked to EW about his internal teenage boy struggle.
They came up with the idea of the false teeth and fat suit I had to wear for several years.
I didn't mind it until I was 14 or 15 and there were girls on set. I was a bit like,
why is it always me?
Number 14. The cast went through a lot of physical transformations over the years. One of the many reasons Rupert can't go back and revisit the Harry Potter series is because he'd spend too much time cringing at his awkward teenage years. He talks to Teen Vogue about his biggest regret. "My hair in film 4 is one of my biggest regrets. We went through our puberty on camera. You kind of see it all. It's very cringy." Number 15. We don't blame you on this one, Maggie. One thing Maggie Smith hated about filming any of her scenes was waiting around wearing Professor McGonagall's clothes. She told the Evening Standard, "I used to find the most exhausting thing was wearing those hats. They're the heaviest things in the world."
How can you just sit back and say, oh, I thought that was absolutely wonderful. Why would you want to do it again? I thought it was perfect. Never.
From wardrobe malfunctions, rotting food, and painful ear injuries, the cast of Harry Potter really went through the ringer to give us this incredible series. Which scene do you think was the most difficult for them?